Hi everybody, this is Nick, and I'm coming to you with a quick tutorial on how to create this really fun infographic column chart with rounded corners at the ends, at the bottom, and at the top of those columns. Now, we've made videos before about how to make a rounded bar chart or column chart with a rounded end, but you'll know from those videos that that requires that your data is more than 10% on either side of that column, because you have to kind of work with the column chart and insert a new series. But in this way, this is a little bit of a hack that we're going to use. Only in PowerPoint can you do this, and it's probably not the best solution for charts that need to be updated all the time. But if you have a column chart or an infographic like this that is static and you just want it to look really cool and interesting, this is one way to do it. So I'm going to escape out of this slide, and we will go over to this slide and we'll start from scratch. So the first step that we need to do is create our column chart. So I'm going to just go ahead and insert from the placeholder a regular standard 2D column chart. And what we're going to do is we're just going to delete these extra series. We don't need those. This is just for a one series column chart here. And I'm just going to say data this way. And what we're going to do here is I'm just going to insert some dummy data. So let's just do 40%. And let's just do 60%, and let's do, let's actually just do 100% here, because we're gonna need that as a placeholder, and then 20% right here. Now we're also gonna do an extra series right over here. This is gonna be called our buffer, our gray, or actually kind of like our gray buffer series. And this is all going to be 100%. So we'll have 100% on all of these. Perfect. Now this looks like a pretty good column chart. I'm going to go ahead and close the data source. Now we have to do some editing here. I'm going to remove our legend. We don't need to do that. I'm going to update our axis to 100%, because that's going to be the maximum. We'll just keep zero as the minimum there, and I'll hard code that in. And I'm going to go ahead and set my major scale to 100. We're going to go ahead and get rid of the grid lines. We don't need any of those grid lines here. And let's go ahead and just update our text to the size that we want. So here I'm going to update this to aptus narrow. I like that. And we're going to do size 16. And then this will be our categories, and that's going to be aptus narrow as well. And we'll do 16 there. So it looks pretty nice. I like that. All right, now our buffer series, this orange series that's always at 100%, that's going to be gray. So we're gonna go ahead and color those bars gray, kind of a light shade of gray there. And we'll keep our bars here at, keep our 100% bars, or our data bars here at where they are right now. But I'm gonna also add the labels, and then let's go ahead and update this to 16, aptus narrow. And let's color them blue just for good measure. And I'm gonna make them bold because that looks nice. Now you can see that the 100% kind of gets cut off. So let's go ahead in the plot area and just drag this down a little bit so the 100% will always show up. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna overlap these two bars. So what I'm gonna do is click on the blue data bars. We'll go over to the Format Data Series menu and click on Secondary Axis. Now those automatically come together, but you see over here the secondary axis is set to 120%. If I just delete this, it will automatically take the minimum and maximum of the primary axis. So let's go ahead and delete that, and you can see everything gets back into shape. Now what we're going to do is we are going to insert a shape. We're going to insert a rounded rectangle, and we're going to do this for each of the series, each of the bars. I'm going to insert this shape right here, and I'm going to work with this dragging tool to make everything perfectly round. And what we're going to do, I think what we're going to do first is let's just make this a little wider. So I'm going to actually make the gap width just a little bit wider. We're going to do this to 150% there. And then on the blue bars, we'll make sure that the gap width is 150% there as well. So it's a nice sort of effect there, kind of a little bit wider, chunkier bars. On my rounded rectangle here, I'm going to remove the lines. So I'm going to go ahead and remove the outline, no outline. And then we're going to put this, let's just change the color just so we can see it here. I'm going to move this right underneath, and we're going to size it so that it goes to the top, from the bottom all the way to the top of the bar. So let's go ahead and just drag this down like this. You're going to have to eyeball it just a little bit. I'm going to actually move this up to the top there, maybe nudge it just in the center, and then we'll move that down to the baseline there. That looks pretty nice, and I want to make sure that there's no line there, so no outline. Now I'm going to go ahead and duplicate this, Control D, and we're going to move this right over to the next column there, and Control D and Control D. Make sure that they're all centered. You can kind of nudge them and eyeball them so that they look pretty good. And then what we'll do is we'll select all of them. Oops, I'm gonna undo that. We're gonna hold down Shift, select all of these guys, go to the Align tools, and let's align those to the bottom so that they're perfectly aligned, and let's distribute them evenly horizontally. Perfect, so everything looks really nice. Now what we're gonna do is we need to create a white rectangle. So I'm gonna insert a rectangle here, and what we're gonna do is we are going to just wherever this lives, you're going to eyeball this. It doesn't have to be totally exact. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of the outline of this as well. I'm going to move this so that it goes across the whole width of the chart. And let's put it all the way down that way. And let's just move it all the way down to this part right here. I'm going to go ahead and move this down to the baseline, just so it overlaps the baseline just a little bit. Now we're going to turn this white, so it's a white fill. And then what we're going to do is I'm gonna send this, let's just send this one layer back and see what happens, send backwards. Now you can see what we need to do is have all of our rounded corners on the front. So I'm gonna go ahead and send this backwards again, send it backward again, send it backward one more time. So all of my rounded corners are there. Now with the white box selected first, now I'm gonna hold down Shift and select each of my rounded corners. And now we're going to go to the Merge Shapes tools. I have this on my Quick Access toolbar, but you can go to the Shape Format menu and then go down to Merge Shapes right here. And then what we're going to say is, we are going to say Fragment. So fragment those. And now you can see it's kind of cookie cuttered those rounded rectangles out of this white shape. So I'm going to go ahead and just delete each of those individually. And now you can see our beautiful column chart has taken shape. And now what we can do, we're gonna keep that there. Now, this chart was from a placeholder, so normally I could probably just hold down Shift and then group that white rectangle together, but you see the group is grayed out. The reason why that is because the chart is from a placeholder. So we don't necessarily need them to be grouped, but if you inserted the chart manually, not in a placeholder, you could group these things and they could stay in one object. But for this purpose, we don't really need to do that. Now, if you need to update the data, all you have to do, since these are cutouts, we can right-click and you can see, oops, I'm gonna make sure everything is unselected. We can right-click a bar and just like any other chart now, we can update the data. So I'm gonna right-click and say Edit Data in Excel. And now I'm gonna move this down and anything in the Data tab, we can go ahead and update. So the 40%, we can update to 89%. And it goes all the way up. 60%, maybe we can go down to 43%. That 100%, we'll click at 90%. And then that final 20%, let's just go to 45%. And you can see how it updates there in the window. And now you have this beautiful infographic chart with rounded corners, kind of this eraser bar style. And you know, it might not be appropriate for every single chart that you have, but once in a while you want a little bit of a different look and feel for those column charts. And it's one way that you can do this in PowerPoint and nobody will know any difference there. They'll think that you made this chart in some other, you know, sort of business BI visualization platform, but you will know that you made this completely in Microsoft PowerPoint and Excel. I hope you like this video. If you do, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually Excel, PowerPoint, or Word. I hope you all have a great day. I had a great time making this for you. I hope you had a great time watching, and I can't wait to see you all next time.